My lord, everything is settled and arranged for the women cooperative. We have plans for the dairy processing industry, machines for the land tunnel, and...
taking our part this morning.
And so what? The teacher will know. Let's go.
But the principal will know. You know, he normally inspects our legs every morning when we come to school.
You're right. So why don't we wash our legs? That way he won't know now.
Let's wash our legs this way.
Stop it!
What do you know that I'm doing from this spot? And so? Why don't you take your feet washing and do it somewhere else instead of doing it here? And who is she to tell us what to do? If Mama was there, would she say it? If your mother were here, she wouldn't tolerate that. I wash my legs here and there's nothing you would do. Nothing. Now, the water you people are using to wash your feet is enough for three people to bath with. And I think you've said enough to shut your trap.
Gemma, listen to me.
I am not your mate. Look, I am older than you. And I am also the one that goes up that hill to fetch water every morning. You have no idea what it feels like to go up that hill to fetch water.
Fine. That's your problem, not mine.
It's your job.
Chuma, we're wasting too much. We're wasting too much water now. We're already late. Nico, please.
Your mother I play.
To give you a graduation party for you and your friends next week. Yes.
Dad, you know, my birthday is next week. I think we should do two classes in one.
I think that is an excellent idea. Anything for you, my dear. Anything. That's an excellent idea.
Good idea.
My daughter looked wonderful. Now, you were saying about the cooperative.
Yes, we have plan for the dairy processing industry.
Yes.
Thank you.
come now.
Hold on. What happened to my water pot?
What happened to my water pot, you witch?
I don't know.
Will you shut up and stop lying to me? Who did it? Who else did it in this compound if not you?
Mama, just a while ago, Chika and Choma washed their feet with the pot. I don't know who broke it.
What? So you dare think that my daughters are thieves like you? You broke my water pot and you have the guts to insult my daughters.
Eh? How dare you?
I did not How dare you, Doc? Oh, Doc!
I think it is time for you to leave this compound.
For this act,
there will be no food for you for 4 days. Why you didn't die with your worthless mother? I don't know. Why?
Okay.
In spite of my efforts to give you food to eat in this compound, you pay me back with wickedness.
Your bitter bile will chop you one of these days.
Eating it, ma'am. I'm only helping you to crack it.
Are you sure? You know I don't trust you. Alright.
You see the pots I don't want. Eh? I want you to wash them clean.
Eh?
Now, my soup pot.
Stay away from it! Unless you want to go to an early grave. Do you hear me? Do you hear me?
Okay. If you like, you can buckle your face like that.
Okay, please. Don't care. What are you doing there? Get up and do what I told you to do.
Okay, until I get back.
Thank you.
You're welcome, princess.
I've come to see my friend.
Which one of my daughters is your friend?
Udoka. Is she at home?
Yes.
She's at...
Princess, are you sure you want to see Udoka? Not Chika or Choma?
I want to see Udoka, please. Call Udoka.
Hey, princess. This one you've come to see us.
What can we offer you?
I'm nothing. I'm fine. Thank you. Come and see her now. Hey!
Udoka! This is Adora! Look at her. See how beautiful she is. Oh my God. When did you come back?
2 days ago.
Are you serious? Yes. Yeah, you're so fine.
Do you remember to come and see me?
Of see your hair.
Udoka, you know what? I have a new doctor.
Okay, let's go in.
And I bought something for you.
Really? Yes. Thank you. So tell me.
So, the princess still remembers this wretched girl.
Hey, Mama, now, dear.
Hush! Oh. I'm going here to listen to their discussion.
What's wrong with your stepmother? She acted like she didn't know we were friends.
It's a long story. Look, the most important thing is that I am very happy to have you here.
Same here. How have you been?
Oh,
it's been what, three years.
Well, things have not been easy for me. I've had to sit at home all these years, doing nothing. My stepmother refused me going back to school after the death of my father.
What? Why would she do that? Wait, did you forget you were one of the most brilliant students in our class?
Look, let's talk about something else. So how's America?
America was fine, even though the studies were not easy, but I tried my best. Would you still like to go to school? I can talk to my father to do something about it.
You're not serious?
I'm serious.
But I want to go back to school. What am I doing in this village? What am I doing in this house? Hey, look, that would be the best thing you'll do for me, please.
Okay.
Meanwhile,
what's his name? How is Uzo?
You can't believe it. I haven't heard a word from Uzo since he traveled.
That was almost 7 years ago. Oh no, that's not nice. Anyway, I got some nice things for you.
What's happening? Really? So well, coming to see me in the first place. Thank you, all those things.
What a great school.
Thank you so much. Yeah. Thank you. I'm so grateful. Let me see
all right,
you.
No problem. So tell me.
Bye.
Listen, Udoka, you have to come and see me tomorrow.
I'll come, okay?
I'll come.
Sure, you come.
I'll come. Please, my regards to Lolo and Digri.
Okay, no
problem. I'll come later on to see you. Thank you very
much.
Take care. Thank you. Bye-bye. Bye.
She bought them as a family gift.
Will you shut your lying mouth? How can Akalugo's daughter possibly be your friend? As lousy as you are, a liar and a thief.
Mama, you know what? I think she stole your money. Lied and deceived Iwe's daughter in using it to buy all these clothes for her.
Exactly! Mom! You got it, my daughter. You stole my mom.
Mama,
you stole my money!
Mama, I did not steal any money.
Oh.
It was Igwe's daughter that I brought this thing. Will you also when she came in here?
I
now?
Swear, Mama.
You are still lying to me.
Mama, I'm not lying, no.
You are still lying to me.
Don't lie.
On the way.
Uh-huh.
Ha! Look at this. It will fit you very well. Take it now.
It's your call.
It is for her.
It's fine now.
Your own is fine too. Let me get it. Look at this long Maria Maka. 3 for 10 won.
It's your call now.
Okay.
Another one.
For me.
Yes,
Mama.
I'll keep this
Mama, this is not fair. These things are for Udoka. Let us leave them for her now. Eh? I don't want to be part of this.
What is not this?
Echi! We don't have this problem!
Mama, I don't want this!
Chica!
Liva! Mama, Liva!
Liva, where
are you?
Okay.
On.
Let me look at
mother
now.
Mama,
it is good for me.
Mama, this one is fine. It's for the young girls. Young girls?
Yes.
So I am old. Mama, is it because your father is dead? You think I am old? If you knew how I was with Akudo when I was a young maiden, if not for this imbecile wound that kept me this way, you wouldn't have said that what you said now. Yeah, look at another one.
Thank you.
like my dress?
Udoka, is it not fine?
We're gonna try it now. Udo, Udo, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry for what my mother has been doing to you. Okay? Don't worry, everything will be fine, okay? Don't cry.
Udoka! So you have not washed the clothes I brought out for you to wash? Huh? Come on, get back! Come on! Shoot! Useless girl! Oh, so you're looking at me?
You're looking at me? Udoka! Chica, I'm hungry. Chica, I said I'm hungry.
That is the kitchen. Then go and cook for yourself now. Why are you disturbing me?
Mama, I'm hungry. I don't know what is keeping that stupid dog from finishing with the food.
You mean the food is not ready yet?
Yes, ma'am.
Chika and Choma come and help me up with the food. At least that way the food can get ready on time.
What did you say? That my children should come and help you do what? After coming back from their tedious study in school, they should cook for you while you laze around and eat? Milu, get back. Get to that kitchen. If that food is not ready in the next 5 minutes, you will have yourself to blame. Nonsense.
The food is ready.
Oh, it is ready, eh? You are lucky it is. Go and get it. Ate, go and get it! Do you want me to shut you with a idiot? Run!
can go.
Mama, I say you can go.
I'm not taking my own food.
As what? Your own food as what? Udoka, you broke my water pot. And you want to eat my food. Udoka. Get out of my face before I can eat well. I'm off here.
Mama, I'm very hungry. I'm not eating since morning. Please.
Okay, you eat my stick. You eat my stick.
Mama. Mama, do you mean she won't eat anything?
Hey! Your mom, show.
Let her eat now. Mama, let her eat.
She will eat what? Eat what? Have you forgotten what her mother did to me? When she was alive? Because she was the first wife. Your father died loving her more than me. If I were the one that is dead now and she is the one that's still alive, do you think you can have peace in this compound? Do you?
Hey, Mama.
Hey, Mama.
It's not her fault. No, it's not Udoka's fault.
And it is your fault. Don't close your stupid mouth.
Mama, let's go.
Let's go. Let's go. Let's go.
Mama bia foro mo nne, mama bia foro mo nne, mama bia foro mo nne.
Your Highness, I greet you. My elders, I greet you.
Thank you.
It is with humility and gladness of heart that I present to you my son, our son, the first and only medical doctor in New Jersey, Dr. Uzoma Uba. I am immensely grateful that after 7 good years abroad, my son has finally returned home in good health with the proverbial golden fleece. My son, come. I am very proud of you. Thank you very much.
My son, you are indeed welcome. Now we thank the gods for their protection, which they have given you for 7 good years that you spent abroad. Today, my heart is filled with joy because we now have a specialist doctor of our own. Well, I arranged this small reception because I wanted you to meet all the heads of the villages that form the entire kingdom. I wanted you to meet them one on one so you can discuss with them and they can let you know what their health needs are. My son, our son, I welcome you again.
Your Highness, elders of our land, I am honored by this reception. I am indeed glad to be back. While abroad for 7 long and difficult years in the medical institution, I had at the back of my mind to give to my people the benefits of the education I was receiving. In the course of my studies, I was privileged to see the impact of modern healthcare delivery system on the rural people. I therefore vowed that when I come back, I will set up a health facility that will make an impact in our community. Your Highness, elders of the land, I therefore pledge, with the assistance of my father, to set up with all the necessary modern healthcare facilities the first community hospital in Ibueza land.
Ibueza kwenu.
Yeah.
Kwenu.
Yeah.
Kwenu anu.
Yeah.
In the spirit of what we have just heard from our young doctor, Dr. Uba, I would like to promise on behalf of the people, land, any land of your choice, any size of your choice, for the hospital that you intend to build.
Set up the hospital in the city, how will I be able to serve the people? I mean, how do I serve the community?
They either come to you there or wait when you visit. Listen, son, I did not spend my hard-earned money to send you abroad to study medicine so that you come back here and be a village doctor.
While abroad, I did my internship in a community hospital. I saw and felt the impact of modern health facilities on the rural people. I want to do the same for our people here, Dad.
How many people do you think that can afford your services in the village? Is it Uduma and the family? Or Igoka and her disabled husband? Or who?
Mom, I became a medical doctor to serve humanity. And not for money. I want to remain here and set up the hospital.
Remain here and do what? So that tomorrow, the Igwe will use you as his medical servant for the palace. No. You must relocate to the big city.
Dad, my mind is made up. I want to stay here and set up the hospital. I want to give our people the proper health care service that they deserve. Can't you see it? Come on, Dad, try and understand, okay? Well, excuse me, I have somebody to see right away.
Azubike became a teacher and left the village. Uchendo became a pastor and left. My own son became a medical doctor and instead of leaving, he has decided to be a village, a common village doctor.
Now you must make him to understand. You must make him to listen to you, or else you want to be called a village doctor. As for me,
love. So good to see you again.
What are you doing here? Look, just go. I don't want to talk to you, okay? Just go. Go away.
Listen, I know you're angry. I know you won't understand.
There's nothing to understand other than the fact that I don't mean anything to you anymore.
You, do you know that's not true? You mean the world to me. You're one of the reasons why I had to come back home.
I don't believe you. I can't even believe you.
I believe in you, Yudi. All the while I was out there, I missed you so much. I missed you, Yudi. And that's the truth.
How could you put me through all this? You stopped writing to me. No message, not even a card for me to know how you're faring.
All of a sudden, my studies became too tedious, that too time-consuming, that I didn't even have time for myself anymore. Listen, each time I remembered how long it's been that I saw your face last, my heart bled.
7 years. It was 7 years and you don't even know what I've been through. You don't even have an idea of what I've been through.
Sorry.
I thought I had lost you. I thought that maybe you had found someone else and that I didn't mean anything to you again.
Come on, Yudi, how could you ever think like that? You know we've always belonged to each other right from childhood. You're the only one for me and you know it.
I missed you so much.
I've missed you too. Some quality time together.
I've missed you too. You know when I was doing something inside, and my stepmom. Okay, don't worry. Let me just go and finish what I was saying. I'll come and meet you.
Are you sure?
Yes. No, come
on. Yudi. About your stepmother. What about your mom?
My mother died five years ago.
I'm so sorry. What really happened?
Life has not been too easy for me. Stepmom doesn't see anything good in whatever I do. I'm more like a slave in my own father's house.
Why has she been so mean to you?
I don't know. She changed shortly after my father died.
Oh, I'm so sorry about your mom and dad. It's such a pity.
2 years after you traveled, my mother died. And I felt my whole world had come to an end.
My father showed me compassion and affection and every magic. And just 2 years after, my father died. He left me all alone. All by myself. He died and just left me alone.
You don't have to cry, okay? Take heart. Strange things do happen.
So you don't know what I've been through. You don't know what I have been through. If not for my half-sister that shows me some love and affection, I would have died out of frustration. With nobody, no father, no mother, no friend. No you.
Back because of you. Don't worry. Everything is going to be all right. I love you.
I love you too.
promise me you will always love me?
I promise. Promise me that you will stand by me no matter the circumstances.
I promise.
For me?
Come on, you know this is nothing. You deserve much more than this.
Hey, I'll wear this to any ceremony that will happen in the village. Hey! What is this one?
Well, open it and see for yourself.
I don't know how to open it now. Okay, I've seen it. Look at! Oh God, this wristwatch is beautiful. Hey, yeah. Look, it matches this dress, oh. Hey, thank you very much. Thank you. See, gold. Hey, God. Thank you very much.
What's the problem, ma'am? Don't you like the stuffs? You look quite a lot.
I'm sorry. I can't take them. My stepmother, she won't let me wear them. She will seize them from me and share it amongst her daughters and beat me up.
Oh, come on. You mean she's that wicked?
Eh? She's very wicked, though. If she sees these clothes now, she'll collect it and still beat me on top of it.
Don't worry. I'll take you home myself and personally explain to her that I bought the stuffs for you.
So, ma, you don't understand. She won't agree with me. She won't allow me to wear it.
It's all right. I promise you there's not going to be any form of problems, okay? Let's put them together. Let's go. Dad. Dad. Meet Udoka. She's late Mazi Obiako's daughter. Do you remember her?
I see. Where are you taking her this to?
I have some stuff I bought for her, Dad.
Stuff I bought for her? This one. This.
Dad, what's wrong with that?
Matthew!
Sir!
Come.
Dad. Listen. Take all this to something else. Was that just
a bomb? Shut up!
Not right. I mean, these stuffs belong to her.
This one. Well, see me upstairs as soon as she leaves.
For his reaction.
Look, I'm not surprised. After all, the last time I went to your house while you were away, I just wanted to find out if there was any information or to know how you were faring. But your father refused to tell me anything.
He chased me away.
What? Are you serious? But how come you never told me about this?
It wasn't necessary. I mean, it's very obvious your father doesn't like me.
Oh, come on, Yudi. But I like you, and that's what matters. Listen, as soon as I get back home, I'll talk to my father and make him realize that you're the only one that I want.
I have to go now. My stepmother will soon start looking for me.
Sorry then. Bye. Bye.
Meaning of that, Dad? Why did you have to embarrass my guest?
Guest? I beg your pardon. That girl is not worthy to be a guest in this house.
Udoka is my friend and I love her.
You love who? Oh, I can see. Is that why you bought all these things for her? Tell me, what did you buy for me, your brother?
For Christ's sake, Mom, you don't need all these things. You already have more than enough. And what is wrong with me buying things for a girl who is after my heart?
Gail is not even fit to be a housemaid.
Housemaid? I don't even understand what is going on anymore. Dad, you knew her father. He was a respectable and honorable man.
We are more interested in the honor of this family. Uzo, that girl is not right for you.
Exactly.
She's a lot.
Exactly. Listen, I have invested so much in you and expect honor and respect in return.
What honor and respect are we talking about here?
I expect you to continue from the respectable, lofty height that I have attained by associating with the daughters of the high and mighty. Like the Igwe's daughter, for instance. Not single entity, like Obiako's inconsequential daughter.
Well, that inconsequential girl is my choice.
Change your choice.
The list for those invited for the party goes through it.
Okay.
Now, I want you to take these cards and personally distribute all these cards to each of them on the list there.
I'll do that when you meet.
How are you? This dress, give it to Udoka. Tell her to wear it for the party since her stepmother confiscated the ones I gave her. Okay?
Princess, are you inviting Udoka?
Yes. What's wrong with inviting Udoka?
This is a high-class party. Sons and daughters of royalty. And people from prominent homes. Udoka is a nobody, my
princess. Don't you dare. Don't you dare call my friend a nobody.
Sorry, Wines.
Listen, Udoka is my best friend. And I can trust her with my life. Don't you ever speak about her like that again. And I'll appreciate it if you do not cross your jurisdiction as my mate.
Sorry, Linus.
Just blow your hands and get back to me as fast as you can.
Hey. Who is this Udoka self? Who does she think she is? First, it was my princess giving her a box full of clothes. Now she's inviting her to the party again at the palace. Please come. stack those clothes at the back here, the ones on this side. Yeah?
Said I should give you this. Hey. Uh-oh.
And this.
Oh, that's so nice of her.
As if you deserve it.
Sorry, I didn't hear you.
I said, as you attend, the princess would like you to behave yourself. Stay at the corner and don't interact with anyone because they are not your class. Is that understood?
Well, tell the princess that her message is perfectly clear.
It better be.
I've actually come to see one of your daughters.
Really? Oh, which one of them? Is it Chioma or Chika? They're both responsible girls.
No, I'm here to see your stepdaughter, Udoka.
My stepdaughter? Which disease is Udoka suffering from? She is pregnant, or she has contracted a deadly disease. That lousy girl is nothing but a walking corpse.
Mama, she is in perfect health. There's nothing wrong with her.
Yeah. Then why would somebody like you be looking for her?
Well, actually, Udoka and I have known each other for quite some time now. And I've been invited to the palace for a function, and I want her to come with me.
Doctor, are you sure you are with your senses? I mean, why would somebody like you attend a function at the palace with Udoka?
Oh, nothing would delight me more than having Udoka attend that function with me.
Why do you want to disgrace your family? Why do you want to make yourself a laughing stock?
Mama, I am proud of Udoka.
Uzo.
Hey. It's not healthy for you to carry a bucket of water on your head. You should worry about your neck, you know. Come.
I wasn't expecting you here.
Well, Princess Adora invited me over for her party at the palace. I want you to come along with me.
Really? I was also invited for the same party.
Oh, yeah?
Yes.
That means we can go together. So why don't you just go in and get dressed?
Okay. If you step an inch, I will deal with you. Since when did this start? Eh?
Mama, She's only going to get dressed so that we can go for the party. Come on, hurry up.
Doctor, I will not encourage prostitution in my compound.
But she's not a prostitute.
I will not sit and watch you encourage her being men into my compound.
Mama, I'm not in any way encouraging any form of immorality. Besides, we're only attending a party at the palace, so is there anything wrong with that?
I don't care where two of you are going. All I know is that she is not stepping out of this house!
I'm ready.
Where did you get that dress from? Where did you get that dress from? Oh, you're going to steal again. You don't have ever to steal again?
Mama, I did not steal anything, no. I've never stolen before. It was the princess that brought me this dress so I could wear it for her party.
Liar! I said you are lying! Anyway, as far as I am concerned, you are not going anywhere! Do you hear me?
Come on, Mama. Listen, I promise to take good care of her and I'll bring her back in good time. She's not going to stay out late, I promise.
Hey, what is happening? Hey? First, the princess, a whole Akalugu's daughter, coming to visit that wretched girl. Now, Uzoma, the first and only medical doctor we have in this community.
No, I can't allow that to happen.
I can't. Bodoka now wines and dines with the high and mighty. And soon, she will have my children and I licking her foot, just the way her mother wanted me to do. It can't happen. It will not happen. It will not happen at all.
Yeah. But he just came back and started professing love for me afresh.
Yes.
He's so loving, he's so nice, he's so caring.
And he seems to be very polished after all his years abroad.
Yeah, and I'm very happy to be his girl.
Of course you should be happy and a lucky girl like that, I mean. He's the only doctor in the whole of the world, is it?
Yes. Why don't you go back to the party? I want to be with Izzo, you know.
Right. Yeah, exactly. I almost forgot.
Young man in this community. Everyone talks about him, and I'm sure every girl wants him. So you deserve him, Your Highness.
Well, what are you talking about?
What do you expect, Your Highness? Udoka is a common girl. She's an opportunist. You gave her your clothes and obliged her to come to this party. Then she will come in with Dr. Uzo and flaunt herself and take the glory.
Oh,
that is not wrong. I take that as an insult.
Ulamo, Udoka is my best friend. My best friend. What are you saying?
You My princess. The golden gong of Ibweze community. The daughter of Akaluga great himself. Whatever you want in this community is what you should get. No one here stands on you. My princess, think about it.
Such a wonderful party.
Yes, and Princess Adora has been such a wonderful hostess. And a very nice friend.
You can say that again. You know what?
What?
All the time I was abroad, I always thought of you day and night.
How come you never bothered to keep in touch? Not even a late hour or.
Because I believed you'd always be there for me. And that one day, I'll come back and rekindle our love.
Uzo, I have missed you so much. You know, but I always hoped that someday, you know, that you would come back to me.
I am back for you for good. Yudi, I want you to be my life partner.
What do you mean?
I want you to be my wife.
Oh, Uzo.
Is that a yes?
Uzo, yes. Yes, Uzo, yes. Yes.
I wish the night would never end. But don't worry. We have a lifetime to spend together.
I love you.
I love you too.
Yourself a husband.
No, ma.
I'm sure that is how your worthless mother got married. I told you not to go to that party, but you did. And since you have assigned yourself a husband, you will leave my compound right now.
But I've not done anything to this. Hey! Now I only went to a party.
I said, explain me the rubbish. Explain me the rubbish. By the time he is through using you,
you better not come near my compound.
Mama Ujoma and I are just friends
now. That's it. You will explain to the Muna. You are Johnny in the dark with a man you have assigned to yourself without their consent.
Mama, I'm sorry now. I won't do it again.
And you will go to your room now. Get your things together and follow your man friend.
Mama, please, I'm sorry. Mama,
Mama, where is the chica, your sister?
She's inside.
Chica! Chica!
I don't have anywhere to
go. I don't want to hear anything from you. I don't want to hear anything from you. Stop it, you're always like that. Chica! This is my house. Do you hear me? It is my house. And I will do exactly how I feel in it. Do you hear me? Stop. That is how you could not go out to the party because you have a pussy face. Keep complaining and walk here. Bring us to
Mama, this
is
Mama, please stop.
Carry your things down. Udoka.
Mama, I don't have anywhere.
Carry your things, Udoka.
Mama, please.
Udoka.
Where is the girl?
Yes, sir.
Now, what do you want here? What do you want?
Please let me see you, sir.
What for?
Please, my stepmother chased me out of the house. I don't have anywhere to go.
Does this place look like an orphanage or a refugee camp? Does it?
No, sir, please, I don't have anywhere else to go.
Now listen carefully. My son will not and cannot have anything to do with you.
Sir, please, no.
Go out there and look for your type in the gutters.
Please, I don't have anywhere to go.
I said, get out. Martin,
sir.
Throw her out of this place.
Yes, sir.
I don't have anywhere to go, sir. I don't have anywhere to go.
Out.
She says she wants to see the princess.
Princess? Who are you?
I am the princess' friend. Please, I want to see the princess, please.
Princess' friend? Wait here.
What do you want here?
I want to see the princess. Listen, I really have to see her.
The princess does not wish to see anyone.
Please, see, my stepmother chased me out of the house. I don't have anywhere to go to. Let me just see the princess, please.
There is no place for people like you in this house. So, leave.
Please, I must see
this. Now!
I don't have anywhere to go to. Please, I don't have anywhere to go to.
Throw out!
Please, let me just see the princess. Please, let me just see her.
I said shut up and leave! Out!
I'm going!
Will you
please,
stop and leave here?
Please, I don't have anywhere to go to. Let me just see
the princess. What's going on here? What's going on?
Princess.
Stop! It's Udoka. Yes. She said her stepmother chased her out of the house and that she wanted to see you.
And what did you tell her?
I sent her out.
Why would you do that?
Princess,
you can't possibly bring her in.
No,
you will not tell me who to bring in and who not to bring in. Do you understand me?
Udoka, let her go! Let her go!
My stepmother threw me out of the house.
Why would she do that?
I don't know.
It's okay. You can stay here with me. I'll get the maids to freshen you up and do your
thing. Thank you.
Ulama, get the maids to bring her things in and she meet me in my room now.
Thank you.
Anything. If you're hungry, go to the kitchen and cook now.
But you're the one Mama asked to cook the food.
Look, Choma, I'm not Udoka. If you must eat, then you must cook.
Are you not the one Mama said you should cook the food? Mama. Mama.
What is it? What is happening here?
It is Chika. She refused to cook the food you asked her to cook, and I'm hungry.
Chika. Is that true?
Mama, I'm not hungry. If Choma is hungry, let her go to the kitchen and cook. Is that not the kitchen? Please.
Are you disobeying me? Listen, Cheka, I want you to go to that kitchen. Immediately.
I'm not going to any kitchen. I'm not going
Cheka,
anywhere.
Cheka, do you have beeswax in your... Stupid girl. Foolish, nonsense child.
Good morning, Mother.
Hey, Doctor. You're welcome. What can I do for you?
I'm here to see Udoka.
Well, she's not at home. She's not at home. She did not return last night.
That's not possible. I saw her off to the gate last night.
Well, she's not here.
So where could she possibly be?
I don't know. That is why I said you should not go to that party with her last night. Eh? Maybe she has gone to see one of her numerous men friends.
Madam, what did I just hear you say?
So you don't even know? You don't know that Udoka is not a responsible girl. Why don't like my two daughters, Choma and Chika? In fact, Doctor, you are very free to befriend either of them, or both of them, if you want. I just look at them very well.
I'm sorry, madam, but I'm not interested. Please, whenever Udoka comes back, just tell her I called.
Are you sure?
Mama. How could you talk about Udoka in that manner?
Will you shut up your mouth? It is because of you. Stupid, foolish girl.
My liver, you fool.
Nonsense girl. Look at her. Her mates are attacking rich boyfriends. Rich husbands, and she's here. She's here, delaying herself. Google for who knows what.
Good day, Your Highness. Good day, ma'am.
Good day. My child, my daughter has just been telling me about your situation. Now, tell me exactly what happened.
Your Highness,
The princess invited me to her party. So when I got back home, my stepmother beat me up severely for going for the party. And she threw me out of the house.
You mean she drove you out of the house at that time of the night?
Yes, Your Highness. I had nowhere else to go to. So I came here.
I asked her to stay here.
No, she will not stay here. That woman must be made to understand her responsibility. Tell the guards to go to Akudo's house and bring her here so that she can come and explain herself right away.
Okay, Your Highness.
My child, you have nothing to worry about. I'll make sure that she takes good care of you from now on.
Thank you, Your Highness. Thank you.
Yes, gentlemen, go on, I'm listening.
Well, is this issue concerning our son and the daughter of the late...
Oh, no. Please. I don't want to discuss that matter. Please.
I can understand your grievance, Papa. But you are going about it the wrong way.
What is wrong with me trying to make my son smart? Why can't my son listen to me? Why?
Of course he listens to you. But he can listen more on the issues that requires him to listen to his own heart.
A young man that studied abroad, a old medical doctor. After graduating, all his heart could tell him is to go and pick that nonentity for a wife. Ah, come on.
Uzo is choosing a wife for himself and not for you. Have you forgotten our tradition so soon?
It should be a thing of joy that Ozo has finally decided to marry.
Yes, it takes a man a lot to finally choose a wife. And now that Ozo has made that decision, we all must support him.
If my son had married a foreigner, that would have been better for me.
Huh? Are you now saying that foreigners are now better than our own daughters?
Well, in this case,
no, yes. No. You are going about it in the wrong way. What our son needs now is our encouragement.
If the girl is a nobody today, tomorrow she may become somebody. When she becomes your daughter-in-law.
Yes!
I am not interested. All I know is that my son's not going to marry that girl.
What?
Gentlemen. Have anything else to tell me?
It's just this issue of my son's school fees. You promised me.
Well, your check is ready, so you'll pick it up later.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
You remember I told you about my leaking roof, and you made some promises, sir.
No problem. I said that to you before. It's no problem. Okay. Gentlemen, look, something is here for you to freshen up.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
It's okay.
Dad, I still don't understand why you're strongly opposed to my marrying Udoka. She's a nice girl, very intelligent and highly responsible too. I love her, Dad, and I know she loves me too.
Listen, son. Marriage is not an issue of love. It is an issue of position, connection. You see, if get married because of where you want to go and how you want people to regard you. Imagine the children of the two most influential families in the community getting married. That's something good, you know.
It may be good to you, Dad, but it means nothing to me. I love Udoka, Dad. And love knows neither class nor position.
Anyway, that is my position. You must marry the princess. She is my choice for you.
And my choice is Udoka. And nothing can change it.
Marry. I call the shots here. You must do what I want you to do.
Maybe you should reconsider your position.
There is nothing to reconsider here, woman. Is it because I allowed him to set up his hospital here? I will not go back on my word this time around.
I perfectly agree with you.